Hi, welcome to Patents TV. I'm your host, Jenna Falbush. Today, Bev Sharritt, a specialist with patents, is joining us to show us some accessibility features on a Chromebook for students who are blind or have low vision. So welcome, Bev, and thanks for being here.
Thanks, Jenna. I have had a lot of requests as I've traveled throughout the state from teachers for the blind and low vision for accessibility on a Chromebook for their students. It is a popular device, and a lot of districts are going to Google School, Google Docs, Google Drive, and using Chromebooks with their students. And it's great because Google has built in some accessibility to the device. And I'd just like to show the basics today. I'm going to show you first the enlarger tool and then a magnifier tool that you can turn on. And then it also has a built-in screen reader. So those three things I'm going to just show you the basics for. And first off, the enlarger is simple, and you might recognize it if you are a Windows user. Just using the control key and the plus and minus, you can zoom in on the screen. And you can zoom in up to 500%. And zoom back out, or if you are working with a student and you want to quickly go back to the default, you just click on Control Zero. So that takes you back to the default. Now, when you enlarge, you change the format of the elements on the screen. So if a teacher is describing upper left, upper right, that no longer becomes meaningful because the enlargement changes the format so that all of the text can be on the screen. To be able to view the screen, you might want to use the magnifier then if you want to keep the screen in the same format as everyone else. So under in the lower right, you can click on this control panel in the system tray, and there is an accessibility right at the top there. I'm going to click on that, and I have the screen magnifier checked right here. You can check and uncheck that. And in order to activate it, you use Control and Alt and the brightness keys, which are like function keys on a Windows keyboard, but they have like a sunshine or light symbol. So the increased brightness one will magnify the whole screen, and the decreased brightness will lower the magnification. So if you're zoomed in and you can use the touchpad, but I prefer a mouse, and it seems more intuitive sometimes to me and to students with low vision, you can scan the screen magnified, and when you move the mouse, it moves to different zones. So I would envision a student with low vision maybe needing to find a certain tab or text and using the magnifier. When it's magnified, the text is a little pixelated. So if it's not accessible for that student and they need higher contrast, they might go and find what they are looking for. Maybe they want to read all about Jessica Conrad, one of my favorite specialists, and clicking on her, and they're scanning, and oh, here it is, about Jessica. I'm going to click on that. I lost it. So you know, they need some practice at navigating. They'll get it with this. But once they get to the text about Jessica, they might want to zoom out and switch to the control plus again to enlarge it and get to the text. And then just use the arrow keys. And then it'll go through all of the elements, but in a larger text. And this is really big. Jessica Conrad. And here's her specialty areas, but the text you can tell is really crisp. So for somebody that needs that high contrast, there it is. I also thought, not only for blind low vision, for a person who needs or prefers less elements on the screen, the magnifier is a solution and can give you just a small chunk there at one time and there are no distracting pictures all around. And so if you need to simplify the screen, this is also an option for a student that needs that. The Chromebook also has a screen reader called Chromevox that's completely free and built in. And it can be accessed by pressing Control-Alt-Z, easy to remember. I remember it because of Control-Z, make a lot of mistakes. Control-Alt-Z turns it on, and I don't know if you noticed, but at the top of the screen, there is now a black bar. So you know it's on with the black bar at the top. And whatever is written in there is what will be spoken by the screen reader. And if you have a braille display connected, whatever is written there will show up on the braille display, which is a nice feature for a sighted teacher because we're always asking the student to move their fingers so we can see what it says on the display. They won't have to do that. You can see what they're looking at on the braille. The Chromebook keyboard has a key that is a search key. The picture of it is right under the tab and above the shift, and it has a picture of a magnifier on it. And that's called the Chromevox key, and it's kind of the magic key. When you press that and shift together and then use the arrow keys, you can navigate the elements. So I am going to show you how it will read the fabulous Kelly Suding's bio on our Patton's website.
I have a background in general education and special education classrooms.
So I know screen readers can be daunting, but this is very user-friendly. There are tools online, tutorial tools, and lessons you can look up. If you need some help with that, contact me. I like to make a diagram of the Chromebook keyboard and make notes on that as I go, because I know when I taught this as a teacher for the blind, low vision, that rifling through the list of commands isn't really useful, but if I have the diagram there, that really helps to have that visual. The great thing about Google as well is they have tutorials, written and video tutorials, that you can use with their students to go through each of the commands. In any screen reader, there are many commands to learn, and Google has some great tools already built for you. You don't have to invent the wheel there, and to teach your kiddos how to use it.
Okay, well, so she showed us the magnification tool, the zoom tool, and the screen reader tool, and that is on a Chromebook accessibility. So thank you so much, Bev, for joining us today. Those are great features, and if you have any questions, don't hesitate to contact Bev Sharritt or myself, Jenna Falbush, and we hope to see you next time on Patton's TV.